My name is Ellen. I'm the education coordinator here at the Land Trust for Tennessee. And today I'm standing in front of our education garden here at Glen Leven Farm. And we're getting ready for spring here and about to put some plants into the ground. So I wanted to show you today how you can grow your own plants at home with some food that you might have in your kitchen right now. So we're gonna start with a tomato. So this is just a grape tomato that I had at home, but you can use any tomato that you have on hand. What you're gonna do is ask a parent for help to cut your tomato in half. You can also do this with cucumbers or peppers. All right, tomatoes are kind of juicy, so you wanna be sure that it gets the seeds dry out before you plant them. So you'll take a paper towel and kind of smear those seeds onto that paper towel and spread those around. All right, so you'll let those dry for about a day until they dry out completely. Now, I did some yesterday so that I could show you guys what they look like when they're all dried out. So these seeds are stuck on there, but they are dry. So what I'm gonna do is take one seed off of here, and then you wanna get some kind of cup and fill it up with dirt or soil. And you're gonna take your little tomato seed and push it down in that dirt, cover it up just a little bit, and give it a nice water. You're gonna wanna put all of these plants into a really sunny spot in order to grow. So find a windowsill or maybe even a spot outside on a nice day where it will have a lot of sunshine. All right, next is gonna be an avocado. I love avocados. They're probably one of my favorite foods. So I eat a lot of them and happen to have an extra avocado pit laying around. So what you're gonna do in order to grow a little avocado tree, might not produce any avocados for you, but it will still be a cool plant. What you wanna do is fill up a jar or a cup with some water. You wanna fill it pretty high. Woo. And then you're gonna grab some toothpicks. Now the idea is that you're gonna be setting your avocado just down into that water. So you wanna take the bottom of the pit, it's gonna have a little circle on it, and you're gonna stick your toothpicks facing upwards a little bit so that this circle will be down into the cup. So you may need to ask for help with this part as well, because toothpicks can be pointy, but you're gonna stick them in there, and then you're gonna gently set your avocado right into that water. You want it to cover the bottom just a little bit so that the bottom is in the water, and then the tree will start growing out of the top of that. Next up is garlic. You can get a bulb of garlic for like 50 cents at the store, so it's a great one to do, and it's super easy to grow. What you'll do is take one clove and then take the bottom part and get a cup of dirt or soil and just stick that clove into that cup. Cover it up a little bit, give it a good water, and again, just put it in a sunny spot, and that will start to sprout within a few days, maybe up to a week. You'll see that start to grow. All right, last one I'm gonna show you is an apple. Apple's like my favorite fruit ever, so I'm really excited to show you this one. Again, with the apple, this is gonna take a lot of patience, and you might not actually get any more apples out of it, but you can still start to grow a tree, which is awesome. I'm gonna cut it sideways so that we can see the star inside. Is find some seeds in that apple. So you're gonna take your apple seeds and get a paper, another paper towel or napkin, get it nice and wet. Put your seeds into that paper towel, wrap it up, put it into a baggie, and then you're actually gonna put this baggie into the fridge. Again, this is gonna take some patience. You'll see that start to sprout maybe in a couple weeks, maybe up to a month. You can keep checking on your apple seeds to see when they start to grow a little white sprout. That's when you know they're done and can go into some soil. So we'll put that one in the fridge to let it sit for a while. So now that we've planted all these things, let's take a look at what's gonna happen to all these plants as they grow. Next, we're gonna get a sprout. So this is actually a tomato sprout that I planted a few weeks ago, and it's just starting to come up out of the soil, and it grows its first two leaves. Now, after after it grows those first two leaves of the sprout, it's going to keep growing. It needs water and sun, but it will keep growing into a plant like these sunflowers. It'll have more leaves, and eventually those plants will actually grow flowers on them. These sunflowers are really close, but not quite there yet. But I do have some clover to show you some flowers. If you look really closely at a clover, you'll see these pretty purple flowers on top. So if a parent says it's okay, you can actually pull one of those flowers off and take a look inside of it and look up close. It's really fun to do. At this point, there's a really important animal that's going to help these flowers create a fruit. Those animals are called pollinators. Our favorite here at Glen, Leven are bees. We have them here at the farm. And those bees will go from flower to flower and carry the pollen. After that, these flowers will start to develop a fruit that's kind of similar to an apple or an avocado. So that fruit then contains the seeds that we plant. So that starts the whole life cycle over again, and that makes your plant life cycle. Thanks for tuning in today, guys. Join us next time, and we're going to be talking about one of our favorite trees here at Glen Leven. And I'll give you a hint, its leaves are shaped like a fan.